Corner Broadcast. I'm Corrine McDaniel.
And I'm Nick Triplett. I'm glad it's Friday. Having all those snow days threw off my routine.
Me too. The cancellations were widespread through the state due to a storm that recently hit North Central West Virginia.
Some schools had more days off than we did. The storm not only brought snow, but icy road conditions and several days with temperatures below zero.
Now that we are back, it's that time again, report cards. They came out earlier this week. I'm sure everyone worked hard to achieve the grades they wanted.
The GPA you received on the report card will tell you if you are eligible for a spring sport. Remember, you must maintain at least a 2.0.
Now let's see what Lacey has for us in entertainment.
This week in entertainment, we're talking about the drama department. Students prepared for months with their production Made to Order, which showed on the 16th, 17th, and 18th of January. The audience enjoyed the 60-minute show, but was short compared to all the work the students put into this play. Students were led by director and teacher T.J. Dalton. The class went through the plays and picked a script to read through. And when the class was satisfied with the script, Dalton held an audition exclusively open to the class members. Each student was able to pick their character and try out for the part. Cuts were called, and whoever did the best got the role. Dalton remarked that there were as many cuts as there were performers. However, Dalton was not the only person putting his all into this production. Students ran the sound, lights, and made the props. They designed and printed the flyers for publicity as well. Marissa Shine ran the lights and sound. Levi Lance was in charge of making the set, with Carla Pulling being an assistant and a stage manager. Actors and actresses were in charge of their own makeup and choosing their costume. The cast was also devoted to several hours in the previous months to after school practice held twice a week, as well as class time rehearsal. For a 60-minute show, hours of work were required to make it the best production it could be.
Our play is Made to Order. It takes place in like the 1940s, I do believe. And it's about how there are two maids in this house for wealthy people, and a blood of the maid shows up and causes a whole bunch of chaos.
My character's name is Winifred, and she's a little girl that falls in love with a kid that is very ugly and gross.
I play Janice. I'm like an assistant, and I'm like really nice and smart, but then as the play goes on, I get irritated, and at the end I like blow up on them.
I am very excited. I mean, the highlight of it all, since I am a cop, I get to eat a sandwich during one scene, which would be really good, and people would be jealous because I'm eating and they're not.
Great job, drama department. Looking forward to your next performance.
I heard theater did a great job.
They usually do. I wonder what else has been going on.
Shelby should have the latest on Around the World.
Thank you, Corrine and Nick. An Italian appeals court convicted former exchange student Amanda Knox and her ex-boyfriend Rafael Solicito on murder charges Thursday night. Prosecutors said the couple had killed Meredith Kircher in November 2007. They were convicted 2 years later of murder, but those charges were overturned on appeal in 2011. A judge said Thursday that Knox, also convicted of slander, was sentenced in absentia to 28 and a half years in prison. Solicito's sentence was 25 years. Knox, who was at home in Seattle, Washington, said her conviction would bring no consolation to the Kircher family. Legal analysts debated whether or not the U.S. would send Knox back to Italy if Rome requests extradition. It is unlikely that Knox will return to Italy to serve additional prison time because U.S. law dictates that a person cannot be tried twice on the same charge, a legal expert told CNN. Knox has said she is afraid to return to Italy, where she has spent 4 years behind bars. The retrial began in September, refocusing international attention on the case that grabbed headlines in Italy, Britain, and the United States, but neither Knox nor Solicito were present in court. It has renewed questions about the effectiveness of Italy's justice system, given widespread doubts over the handling of the investigation and key pieces of evidence. Both Knox and Solicito have maintained their innocence. This has been Around the World in 60 Seconds. I'm Shelby Bennett.
Wow, that's a pretty serious event.
It sure was. The sports teams here at PB have been killing it too. Here's Bryce to give us the rundown.
Welcome to PB Sports. Let's find out how our Colts have been doing this week. The weather is no match for our sports teams, because no matter what Mother Nature throws at us, we fight back. Let's start with some hoops. On Friday 31st, JV and varsity boys had a game at home against North Marion. The JV killed it and came out with a victory. It was a close game, but in the end, they won by 4 points with a score of Phillip Barber 78, North Marion 74. The varsity boys played hard in their game at home against North Marion. In the end, they fell short of just a few points. The final score was North Marion 84, Phillip Barber 75. Boys varsity had another game on Wednesday, February 5th. The score of that game was Preston 84, Phillip Barber 58. The girls also played Preston on Wednesday, February 5th. They had a close game with a score of Preston 54, Phillip Barber 46. The girls basketball team had a game at Preston County and were tough, but luck wasn't on their side in that game. At the half, Preston was winning by 18 points, and the Lady Colts were defeated by a score of Preston 62, Phillip Barber 41. Better luck next time. The weather prohibited a lot of basketball games, which will be rescheduled. Listen to the announcements for more information. Now let's hit the match with wrestling at PB. They had their match on Saturday, February 1st at Petersburg, West Virginia. Junior Drew Darty won by pin in the 195 weight class against Joshua Prophet. Junior Travis Pomp was another victor in the 220 weight class. He won over Yancey Skinner by a close decision. Pomp went 8-1. Senior Ian Newsom also went 8-1 and won his match in the 126 weight class. And freshman David Murphy also came out victorious in the 120 weight class. Another winner that day was junior James Bell in 160 weight class, another 8-1 victor. Now let's dive into the pool with swimming at PB. The swim team had Big Ten championships in Clarksburg last Saturday. The girls' medley relay team, which finished fourth place, and the girls' 400 relay team that consisted of Jordan Bowers, Cheyenne Taylor, Abby Blankenship, and Skylar Foster came out second place. In individual events on the girls' team, Ivy Blankenship got third in the 100 freestyle with a fantastic time of 104. Jordan Bowers was awarded third in her 500 freestyle with a time improvement of almost 4 seconds. The team had many personal records broken along with school records broken. On the boys' side, the 4x200 medley relay, which consisted of Joey McGuire, Jonathan Franklin, Shane Mitchell, and myself, got third place. Also, the other boys' relay team got third also. Shane Mitchell got fifth in the 500 free with a time of 2:25.25. PB had two Big Ten champions. Jonathan Franklin was awarded first in his 100 breaststroke with a time of 1:08.47, and I myself was awarded first along with my 100 butterfly with a time of 1 minute. Way to go to all the sports teams. Now let's get back to Nick and Corrine.
Great job, as usual, Colts.
Absolutely. Now let's see what's coming up next for the Colts with Lily and Jenna in upcoming events.
All of the dates are jumbled, but we've got them sorted out.
February 15th through the 22nd is National FFA Week, with the FFA Scholastic Competition occurring on the 17th of that week.
Swim regionals are being held next week, and boys basketball has a busy schedule due to all the snow days.
On February 11th, the freshman boys team will be playing at home at 6 o'clock versus Grafton.
On February 12th, the varsity team plays at home, also versus Grafton at 7:30. The freshman team will play at 6 o'clock in Bridgeport.
On February 13th, the freshman team is versing East Fairmont at 4:30. The JV team plays at 5:45 and the varsity team plays at 7:30.
And the varsity team plays again at home on the 14th at 7:30, playing Liberty.
The girls' basketball teams will be playing on the 11th as well, versing Grafton beginning at 7:30.
And on the 15th, both girls' teams will face East Fairmont at 6 p.m.
On to wrestling. The Big Ten tournament is being held at Buckhannon tomorrow, which will start at 10 a.m.
The team will also travel to Preston on the 12th, and the matches will start at 6 p.m.
And finally, on the 15th, wrestlers will face opponents at Grafton starting at 10 o'clock that morning.
And don't forget, the 14th is Valentine's Day, and we have a 2-hour early dismissal.
And that the Harlem Globetrotters are being sponsored by the junior class to play in our gym at 2 o'clock this Sunday the 9th.
And Winterfest is tomorrow. Starts at 8 p.m. and ends at 11.
Well, this concludes the dates to remember.
Until next time!
The Colts Corner has been working hard to bring you a new segment of the broadcast.
That's right. Here's Michaela with PB Speaks Out.
The Colts Corner wanted to get you, the students at PB, more involved in our broadcast. We are starting a new segment entitled PB Speaks Out. Each week we will be asking you a poll question to get your thoughts on a particular issue. Our first question we wanted to see is who you thought would win the Super Bowl. To the 58% that were expecting the Broncos to win, boy were you wrong. Seahawks dominated with a final score of 43-8. Super Bowl 2014 was a blowout, but it was the most watched TV show in history, so it may not have been exciting, but it sure drew TV ratings. Now let's see what some of you have to say about the big game.
I wanted the Seahawks to win because they have an outstanding defense and their quarterback can make the big plays.
I honestly thought the Broncos were going to win the Super Bowl, having almost the best record in the NFL. And I kind of wanted them to because of what Richard Sherman did after the 49ers game, but he made up for it in the Super Bowl.
That wraps up this segment of PB Speaks Out. Back to you, Corrine and Nick.
That concludes this broadcast. I'm Corrine McDaniel.
And I'm Nick Triplett. See you next week for the latest at your school.
Let's rage. And here you were, you were gonna come to me. And here you are, but you better choose carefully.